my philosophy of self-defense when we know a fight is imminent. Not that I'm looking at somebody grabbing you from behind and throwing you on. Or when you start throwing up and throwing you on. When you know something's coming. Okay? My philosophy is first and foremost, shoulder cut. First and foremost, shoulder cut. Because then comes in the wild haymaker, bang, good stance, bang, good counterattack. Much like a point spiral. Okay? Now, if he's finished, fantastic. The big days, boom, now it's huge. Fantastic. Right? But if it wasn't so successful, okay, now there's room. And now he's angry. And now not only is he angry, he can now adjust to my tactics. Because he knows that I'm coming from. Okay? He doesn't know what to juke out, but he knows this guy has a fight. So he's going to have a plan now to counter that. He's not going to go, oh, last time I was unsuccessful, maybe this one will work. No, the guy knows how to fight, then take him down. Then he can't use those fancy fists of his. Okay? Got no fist of fury if he's on the ground. So first and foremost, shorter time. I'm going to fight, I don't want to fight, bang, bang. If I get the opportunity, I'll take him out with a broken kick straight up. If I don't, now I've got Goju. Because Goju is more my grappling, close quarter. So that's why if it's already on straight away, and you're in, you just go, boom, 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 push away, I'm straight into the Goju. Okay? This Goju needs to be my cat stance, Goju needs to be my groin, which is so important for real life. Okay? However, if I just stand like this, it's probably not just going to rattle me. You might move around, you might, whatever. And now it's very hard for me. It's very hard for me. Okay? So one of the things you can work on. Second thing is, if anyone knows anything about the Miyagi brought Goju to Japan, from Auckland brought to Japan. And what happened is that when some of the old Japanese go, what's this karate style thing that's going on that I hear about that they think is so good? And all the judo guys came to challenge them, sumo wrestlers came to challenge them quite regularly. Because the karate guys are just going bang bang. Because the judo guys are not used to people punching them. So when you're really good at grappling and suddenly you're not used to being punched in the face, suddenly you're not so good at judo anymore. Okay. So the judo guys walked out and karate rules. Okay. And that didn't last long. Because what happened was the judo guys go, these guys know how to use those fists. So they let their fists out. So judo, rather than going to here to start with, because you've got to get through these weapons, they changed it to here. Let's go for the weapons and grapple from the weapons. Because now the weapons aren't so successful anymore. You can take those fists of fury away, they can't do so much. Right? So again, judo originally here, punch me in the face. Judo changes to here. Now, where's your fancy karate? Right? So the judo guys won. So the judo guys won. Judo rules. Karate failed, right? But then karate worked out, you've got to adapt. Because these people who want to take us down, who want to beat us up, basically, they kind of work out, once they know that they don't have to use these, they try to nullify these. And that's how an average person can average stuff and think, but I imagine. You know, person must have used those fists, I'm going to grab them. I'm going to go for a big grappling tackle, get underneath them. Now let's do this, right? Or I'm going to go for grabbing them. They're hard, but you can't use them. So the karate guys work out, we've got to take our weapons away from them. Because now, you can't see my arms. You have to go back to the original body. And when you go back to the original body, I've got my weapons, right? So they developed a system which is known as data root, which just means data is just moving. Have you ever seen things like this in movies? They developed a system that was data root, which was just taking away the weapons. You've still got your weapons, you just don't have your guns moving, you've still got your weapons, you've still got shoes over your elbows, eyes over, you've still got loads of stuff, okay? But rather than this, I'm here. I can still block, I can still strike, I can still strike, I can still elbow, I can still do 100 things. But what I'm doing is I'm taking them away, okay? So again, real life fighting, the words I kick anyone in the groin. So if you want, that is a kick in the groin. No higher than that. So no one even gets scared about being kicked in the groin. Okay? Just to get the idea of that. And what I want you to practice is the idea of, if they do get their hands on you, if they do get their hands on you, that your hands are free. There's nothing but your eyes. I can do lots of naughty things. Hey? Make sense? So, and when we're moving, we always make sure to move with cat sense, cat sense, cat sense, cat sense. When you're using, that's what we do for this exercise. Hey? Okay. Since they're brand new, they're in the bug.
Right.
sometimes it's just more of a past that, just lose that edge. If you keep it right, at some point, you probably will lose that edge. Dachi used to compete in tournaments. Shihan used to compete in tournaments. They don't do it anymore. Most are passionate about karate because they just understand it's more to do with tournaments. Tournaments are the 1% you've got on the side. The only real advantage of tournaments is that they just have to train hard because it gives you a reason to want to be better. Right? Start to get a bit bored. Right?